What would lead a man to give up his badge? Especially a man like Phil DiNatale.
I was very upset over the whole thing. I thought the public should know that he was or wasn't the Boston Strangler so they can rest at ease over the whole situation. And I thought it would have been only fair to the public that they tried him.
Tried him for murder.
For murder of the Strangler. So the public could rest at ease and say, gee, they finally got him.
DiNatale says he will always be disappointed that DeSalvo was convicted of lesser assault charges, leaving the stranglings officially unsolved.
It bothers me that we haven't gone to court, but we have the evidence. Albert DeSalvo is the evidence himself. He wants to confess to it. He wants to confess to things that only the strangler himself would know.
So then, what was preventing the state from convicting Albert? The short answer is politics.
They were satisfied that they got him on the rapes and B&Es.
But it wasn't just for one reason. There were a slew of things going on, one of which was that Phil was the last man standing trying to seek a conviction. He was the last one to stay on in the state house, and because of his determination, he was burning bridges along the way.
Nobody wanted me to see DeSalvo anymore. They just wanted to drop it and let it die.
Not only was Phil the only one who wanted it buttoned up in a court of law, but politics got so much in the way that when Phil was sent back to the Boston Police Department, he was getting put on scut work.
Instead of going back in the job, now the police commissioner, Edmund McNamara, hated Phil. So when he came back, he was doing scut work. He was answering a phone, he was picking up the captain's laundry, running errands, and basically they were rubbing his face in it.
But at that time, you had a commissioner that was blind with hatred because a little guy like me come up with the answers. He didn't want me to come up with them.
But rubbing Phil's face in it wasn't going to shut him up. And the same applied for DeSalvo.
I don't know if you realize it or not, but I respect you, and I think you're a great guy. I have very few people who can understand me, and less who can believe me. I'm not trying to prove anything. I hate all this as much as you, Phil, and everyone else. I guess this is why I'm fighting so hard to be heard.
Albert was rattling his cell bars in hopes of making some money to support his family by selling the rights to his story.
And Albert became very disenchanted with what had happened to him. While he initially was behind the whole movie being made in 1968, he initially became disenchanted with that also.
And eventually, once Hollywood did make a movie based on the book about the stranglings, Albert continually tried to sue 20th Century Fox with claims that he wasn't competent to sign any releases.
I truly don't wish to go into court anymore. It's doing only harm to my family. So you can see I'm better off dead.
However, it was during the court cases that Phil was called to the stand and presented some of Albert's letters. These were used to prove that DeSalvo was competent, knew about the making of the motion picture, and even had made a leather wallet for director Richard Fleischer that Phil gave to Fleischer from DeSalvo. This betrayal of DeSalvo makes me wonder if Phil was selling out to Hollywood. Or was it simply that he was so by the book that the law ordained him to present any evidence he had? But how can you sell out a serial killer? So in the end, Phil gave up his badge to work on the production in hopes of getting the story out there. But ultimately, Hollywood made the movie they needed to make, leaving Phil to his own devices to try and get the real story of the Boston Strangler out into the public sphere. And until his death in 1987, he continued to put his story on record through audio recordings and even told his two sons all the ins and outs of the case while the two began working for him in the middle 70s. The older son, John, to this day, has kept his father's story safe in exactly the way he left it, in hopes of putting it to record, showing how Phil DiNatale had solved the case of the Boston Strangler, but ultimately was shut out by politics and mainstream media.